Congratulations! You clicked on the most boring possible thumbnail title combo that I was able to come up with. You win the prize of watching a video that's not actually the boring thing you thought it was. That's not entirely true. But first, before you continue watching, I want you to smash that dislike button! Because I'm doing an experiment. I want to see if it's going to destroy my channel momentum, which I am fine with. I just want to see what's going to happen. Smash that dislike button! Let's get to 1 billion dislikes. Tres Comas Club. Hombre. I was inspired to do this because I saw some incredibly boring topics from NAB one year. So, stuff like this. Designing and troubleshooting a robust SMPTE ST2059/PTP network. Gosh, and the description is just as dry. I thought, boy, that's a really boring title. Can I come up with an even more boring title? And I did a bunch of internet searches trying to find the most boring titles. And the winner I decided was Approximation and Weak Convergence Methods for Random Processes with Applications to Stochastic Systems Theory, Signal Processing, Optimization, and Control. This is a real book, ladies and gentlemen. It exists. I don't know what this book is about. I have no idea. Okay, let's continue with our list of boring things. The Institutionalist Approach to Public Utility Regulation. Practical TCP/IP. Designing, using, and troubleshooting TCP/IP networks on Linux and Windows. Okay, so the problem with this one is that I can recognize the words Linux and Windows. If you were to delete that, now we have no idea what this is about. Let's see, linear systems and signals. Yeah, that's quick and to the point. A comprehensive history of the applications of potassium. I might actually click on that. Potassium. Periodic videos. Yeah, it's got 1 million views. You know, that's not boring enough. Client data and management information coordination. The exchange of goods and services in pre-Sargonic Lagash. The design and construction of reinforced concrete structures. That's not actually that boring. Yeah, so this is one of the results from people trying to find the most boring book title ever. Phonetic feature definitions, their integration into phonology, and their relation to speech. A case study of the feature NASAL by Pieter T.H. van Rienen. Gosh. The preliminary and interim report on the Hebrew Old Testament text project. Yeah, I've seen boringer. Studies in Greek color terminology. Mnesonine Bibliotheca Classic Petava Supplementum. Okay, so this isn't boring as much as it is impossible to understand. These are just words that people are not familiar with. To be truly boring, it has to be recognizable words. Scattered hegemonies, post-modernity, and transnational feminist practices. See, this is much more boring, but feminist is a word that I recognize. So if we just remove that, kind of like removing Linux and Windows, now it becomes far more boring, and I have no idea what it's about, even though it's in English. Okay, Colonial Inquiry, speech of the Honorable Francis Scott, MP, on moving the appointment of a select committee, London, 1849. This might actually be the most boring one on here. That is so boring. A speech about moving an appointment of a selection committee? Like, what is this? Hawks and Hjerting, the potatoes of Argentina, Brazil, Paraguay, and Uruguay. A biosystematic study, Oxford, at the Clarendon Press, 1969. You know, I think adding a date makes it more boring. because it's like, wow, even if this was interesting, it's out of date and there's no reason for me to read it. The noun phrase in ancient Greek, a functional analysis of the order and articulation of NP constituent in Herodotus. All right. Okay, the economics of education. This is another one that inspired this. Okay, so check this out. This is from the book Rich Dad, Poor Dad. When I came out with my first book, If You Want to Be Rich and Happy, Don't Go to School, a publisher suggested that I change the title to The Economics of Education. I told the publisher that, with a title like that, I would sell two books, one to my family and one to my best friend. The problem is that they would expect it for free. The obnoxious title, If You Want to Be Rich and Happy, Don't Go to School, was chosen because we knew it would get tons of publicity. So I chose a title that would get me on more TV and radio shows, simply because I was willing to be controversial. Many people thought I was a fruitcake, but the book sold and sold. I've got some results from the NAB search here. New technologies for automating syndicated programming management. God. And then here's the description. For many years, local broadcasters have relied on syndicated programming to fill daily schedules and barter spots for them from this programming to enhance local revenues. Traditionally, syndicated content. I'm so bored. I can't continue. Let's go to the next one. Redundant multipath time transfer and sync for media networks using SMPTE ST2059-2. So acronyms can be boring, but if you're only using acronyms, then it's not boring as much as it is just, I don't know what that means. But in this case, like, this is very boring. Okay, practical multi-vendor application of ST2110, technical challenges and solutions. So, if you can think of more boring titles than these ones. Oh, I have a list of boring words that I've discovered. Solutions, management, economics. You know, pepper these through your speech and watch people's eyes glaze right over. And I feel like I have to put a disclaimer because people get their, never mind. I'm not saying that all of these things are boring or that you are boring if you've engaged with these things. I'm just saying that these titles are boring. I didn't even come up with the titles. Okay. The remainder of this video is literally just going to be this guy giving a lecture with no sound. Even if you were interested in what he's talking about, too bad. And I'm literally just doing this so that the automatic thumbnail thingy will pick this up as the thing that happens when you hover over the thumbnail. Now, I mean no offense to this gentleman. He's more accomplished than I am. I'm not going to tell you who he is or what this lecture's about. It's in the Creative Commons. That's why I'm using it. But I simply want for this video to be as unengaging as possible. So again, don't forget to dislike. Don't forget to not watch the rest of it. Just go away. I promise you there are no Easter eggs in any of this footage. It's literally just this for the rest of the video. Thank you for watching, and good night.